today. From Raymond James Stadium in Tampa, Florida, it's Week 7 of the NFL on EA Sports.
Considered a wonderful fall afternoon for football here in Stadium, the scene a few moments ago. Teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Carolina Panthers. Alongside Charles Davis. And Charles, you take a look at this Buccaneer ball club. They were winners last time out, so they'll be looking, Charles, to make it two in a row.
And what I enjoyed when I watched their game tape and their victory last week is they put it together in every phase. Good offense, good defense, and some key plays on special teams. Let's see if they can get that second win in a row.
On the other side of the field for the visiting Panthers, they've come in on a nice
last week. They had things humming. If you're a defensive player, you may get overshadowed a little bit, but you're really buoyed by what your offense is doing.
Getting toward the halfway point of the NFL season, Week 7 is underway on EA Sports. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And this will go as a touchback, and they will begin things at the 25. First try on offense for the Bucs and their veteran quarterback, Tom Brady.
I guess we have to nickname him the thrower, aren't we, or something
after
like that.
After last week?
I mean, man, you're talking about over 400 yards throwing the ball. The running backs and everyone else may be looking at him like, hey, don't forget us. And he'd probably just tell him, listen, you want to get involved?
Go out.
Go out and catch some passes. I'll make sure you touch it.
On first down, Brady. He gets it into the hands of Gronkowski. Complete. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7. Past the 30 to the 32. 7 yards, the pickup there.
Defensively here, you're facing a top 5 team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic.
Yeah, that's why I mean
20 points score.
That would explain a lot.
You give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout. And that means
Jones won't quite get the first.
There, and it's going to lead them to third down. An early test for this defense. Here we go on third and inches. They'll try and run for it with Jones.
Boy, he's going to get stuffed in the backfield for a loss.
Behind the line there. Losing 2 yards that time, and now it's fourth down.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
Oh, real mature.
So on now is the Clemson man, Bradley Pinion, to punt this one away. Christian McCaffrey.
And the Bungles win.
They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. A 45-yard punt.
Yeah, last year we really had our time.
And the Panthers will take over now, first and 10. So here are the Panthers now for their opening drive. And they will be led out by their 6'6" quarterback,
Trevor Lawrence.
Despite the 3 touchdown passes he threw, there's a lot to work on this week, wasn't there?
Oh, ton of interception.
Yeah, I mean, when you're going really with almost a 1-to-1 ratio, that's not going to work for you well at all. Not over the long haul. The beauty, though, somehow found a way to win.
Yeah, he still got the win last week. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
A 6-yard pickup.
brings up second and four at the 29.
I think the Boston College game was our best game of the year.
Handoff now to McCaffrey.
And that's going to be going back.
And now room to run. And he's going to be holding. Taken down here with a penalty flag on the field.
Damn it, Gerald Everett.
So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
That's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw.
Oh, damn. Yeah, that was a mistake.
Incomplete.
And Lawrence can't hook up.
Barron down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw.
And Higgins. Higgins was the intended receiver.
So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
And a fair catch call for him just inside the 35-yard line. A
41-yard
punt there with no return. And the bucs will get ready to go on offense. Brady going to bring the bucs up with a first and 10 at the 34.
And he hits Gronk.
Gronkowski. Brady. And he's going to be stopped up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain there on the completion. Second and 10. Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. Now a toss left side,
and
into
Gronk
the is tight end.
Gets nothing. Gets
5 yards.
Gets
five. It's third and five. I think defensively, you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter,
and
can you do it
the double team.
Long?
And Brady's going to get sacked.
He's brought down. It's a Panther
Shaquem sack. Griffin.
Said there was a lot of discussion in their defensive team meeting room after last week's performance. They had 7 sacks. Something in the water. There's one in the first quarter.
A lot of discussion, a lot of excitement, because now everyone wants to get involved with this. Who's going to continue that process? Who's going to get to the quarterback this week? But they have to be careful. When you have that much pressure, they want to use it against you. Draws, screens, those types of plays.
See if they do that. They've got good starting.
But the thing is, though, they're getting
first and 10. At their 35-yard
it's
line.
Not like they're all, okay, no. Yeah, at first I don't see that extra high safety. I was like, okay, yeah, now I see you. You almost got me there.
You guys run here early on. It doesn't take a great play call to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber who runs like this early, because it will pay dividends as the game progresses.
And McCaffrey will get the first.
McCaffrey, the ball carrier. And Dominican Sue on the stop. A 4-yard pickup on the play. First down. They'll look to throw here on first down. Into heavy traffic.
Wait, what?
Picked by Antoine Winfield Jr. And he'll bring this all the way up to the 45-yard line. The rookie was trying to put.
Wait, I'm so confused. Oh, okay, yeah, fair enough.
Downfield, but the safety bit him.
And he'll learn that you have to hold the safety. And you do that with your head movement, your eyes, sometimes your shoulders. Hold the safety so that you can get back to the throw that you're.
And Brady's going to get sacked. Shaquem Griffin.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. Second and 24.
Now it's going to be a quick pass.
Complete on the hitch route. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
Complete to Mike Evans.
The Panthers turn to their nickel set here as they get ready for third down. From the gun, it's Brady. That's complete to his receiver, Godwin.
And Godwin is not going
to
go anywhere.
3-yard line. The completion good for only 6, and that'll bring up 4th.
One of the money routes for any offense, the drag route. So tough to defend because the receiver can stop at any point and make himself available to the quarterback and get a completion. But I love the communication we saw there. All the defenders pointing out the receiver, where he was going, and then they're able to rally to the ball after the catch and stop him short of a first down.
At their own 21. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. The results not great thus far. A punt on the first drive and an interception last time out.
Now let's face it. Okay, if he could have beaten him off the line.
Play with some confidence, play with some tempo, play with some rhythm. And when you're making those types of mistakes, you're not getting any of that put together.
So what do you say, time to get back to the basics for them?
In a lot of ways, yes, but the biggest one, of course, is finding people who will take care of the football and make a few plays. You've got to have a drive now that calms down the entire team.
He was brought down by Levante David. A 3-yard pickup. And it's
on third down, he'll drop to throw.
Pass gets dropped.
Incomplete.
You're going to need to do against those big receivers. You got to get in there and get physical with them. That time he got in close, got in tight, and knocked the ball away.
No gain.
41 yard punt, just 1 yard on the return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Brady and the Buccaneers here, first and 10, right at the 30. Out of the gun, he'll throw. He finds his target.
And it's Mike Evans.
And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. The numbers.
Oh, shit.
Evans a week ago, well north of 100 yards receiving, he was hard to stop.
He
the only
should have
his
X factor.
They didn't allow him to get in the end zone.
And that's small comfort for them because he actually carved them up. I love his versatility. I love his route running. Ran entire route tree.
Picked off! And it's Edmonds.
The safety Terrell Edmonds picks it. And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line.
Acquired from Pittsburgh.
Really nice interception. I think it illustrates the differences between playing man and playing zone. When you're in man, all you're focused on is the receiver in front of you. But when you're in zone, you're allowed to read the quarterback's eyes and go to the ball. That's exactly what happened on that play.
And this one's going to go the wrong way. Losing yardage back at the 42.
They rarely do the
loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. He'll get this to McCaffrey.
He hits McCaffrey.
And he's going to get down to the 33-yard line here.
The second down.
Give him 9 on the play. And all of a sudden here, it's third down.
A 9-yard gain on the play.
They'll try and pick it up with McCaffrey. And he will be very close to a first down.
Yeah, he won't get it.
Close fist to the referee. And that means fourth down. Give him a yard on the play, and he's definitely short. It'll be fourth down in a few inches.
I bet they thought they had picked that one up because it was a 3rd-and-2 call. And they got awfully close. Now we're at 4th-and-inches. I wonder if they think they're feeling lucky here and maybe want to go pick it up.
Max protect.
Back to throw here. He'll take a shot for the end zone.
Touchdown!
In the end zone for the Carolina touchdown.
Carolina.
By DJ Moore. DJ Moore with touchdown number 7 on the year. As his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon.
If you did know it, it won't surprise you to find out that this team leads the league in scoring. They've been a quick strike team all season long. There's another example. They did it again. This offensive coordinator, right now, you can write his ticket towards being a head coach. He's advanced in the ways of offense.
But only if there was an offensive coordinator. But there is none on this team.
Now this will make it into the end zone. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. They're still in search of an initial first down as they come up here first and 10. A run there on first down going nowhere as he stopped right at the 25.
He's brought down by...
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
On On second down, it's Jones.
Jones
and
goes nowhere.
This one up to the 26.
Some of these play calls, I think they're a little conservative, but you know me, because it's easy to sit up in this booth, right, and make all the calls and think I'm going to be correct. But I would like to see that
Shit.
Open things up, because otherwise
an easy yard short.
Up on the run and set them down.
And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth.
Now, that's going to be a tough one to explain when they get together and watch a game film, isn't it? I mean, they had the right call, had the out route. He's got to know where the first down sticks are, yet he steps out of bounds that close. Not their best play.
A 40-yard punt, give him three on the return, and that will come the offense as they take over. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Things progressing to plan so far. Their defense has been solid, and they've got themselves a 7-0 lead after the touchdown the last time they had the ball.
And this is no time to even think about, hey, are we going to milk the clock?
And it's going to be caught!
And he finally goes down at the 23-yard line.
A 51-yard gain.
So barely time to catch our breath. Here's first and 10 just outside the red zone. This is McCaffrey on the give.
And McCaffrey gets it. And
first down inside.
He'll be in! Touchdown, Carolina!
Panthers touchdown. Christian McCaffrey, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Panthers are able to grow their lead. CD, for them, this has just been an offensive explosion here in the second quarter.
Yeah, held scoreless in the first quarter. Now they find the end zone again here in the second. Sometimes you just have to have some patience. A lot of people think it's always an adjustment and you have to change what you're doing. Sometimes you just have to do your game plan just a little bit better. And I think that's part of what we're seeing here.
The extra point now coming from Myers.
The kick is up, and it is no good.
It's no good. Missed the PAT, so they fail to connect, and this remains a 13-0 game. So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. This taken in about 4 yards deep, and it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
At the 33-yard line.
Here's a throw over the middle.
It's
taken
and
it's
going to be Gronk.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
At the 42-yard line.
Now a first down carry by Jones. And able to work about 5 yards out of this as he's taken down up near the 47.
The tackle made at the
Brandon 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300+ pounders at the line of scrimmage.
They knew it was a run up the middle.
Significant chunk of yardage.
The ball carrier.
I can't help it because I'm just sitting back in admiration right now of what I'm seeing. This is a defense that essentially announces to everyone that they're going to play, you are not running the ball against us. I don't care how you try to go about doing it.
Number one rush defense in the league for a reason. And after that last play, they might want to try to go to the air. That gain of 9 buys them a new set of downs. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Shotgun now for Brady. And this is caught by Evans.
Mike Evans is hoping he can make plays.
Down. 4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and 6.
Second and 6 at the Panthers 38-yard line.
Working from the gun, it's Brady. That's caught by the tight end.
Caught by O.J. Howard.
Out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
First and 10 at the 28.
Brady now on first down. And that is incomplete.
Pass almost.
He couldn't hold on through the contact.
Pass got broken.
Second down. Some of the fan fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all, and I understand why. They look lethargic, out of sync, and it shows on the scoreboard.
Brady's pass there, complete to Gronkowski, and inside the 20 before he's brought down. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
Dimpin' and dacking his way down the field. Pathetic.
Brady gives this one off to Jones. And he's
Jones is not going anywhere.
In on the stop, it was the UCF product, Shaquem Griffin.
There on the tackle. No gain on the play. Second and
yeah, you want to talk about Shaquem Griffin having a big game.
Now Brady throwing on second down. Firing quickly here, and that's complete.
Brady's pass.
Down he goes at the 10 with a solid pickup of 8.
Eight
yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
And they have held the ball for actually a pretty long time. And Brady's going to throw his few incompletions.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs. Able to knock down the third down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected fourth down here.
Fuck.
Brady to throw for
touchdown!
And he's in the end zone. Touchdown.
Mike Evans.
Mike Evans. His third touchdown now.
Boom. 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 Kick is up, and it is good.
It took a pretty big risk right there going for it on fourth down, but hey, not only did they get the first down, forget about that, they got in the end zone.
Yeah, because normally you're just thinking, can I get enough yardage to get it past the sticks and pick up a first down? Instead, they go for the end zone and get it done with no margin for error. Remember, fourth down, they went for it.
At their own, the Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They'll try and start this drive in the air.
And Lawrence is going to get sacked.
Pressure too much. Down he goes. Shaquem Barrett put that sack by his name in the stat sheet. After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here.
Caught by Higgins.
Down the middle of the field, and he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll send you cross state to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman will have all the stats and all the scores from games going on during another busy Sunday in the National Football League. Incomplete. He had his hands on it, but couldn't.
Honestly,
it.
Yeah, I like our chances.
Intended for DJ Moore. It's fourth down.
They're going to try and throw.
Pass incomplete.
So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the bucs are going to take over with excellent field position to boot. So shall we say a bold decision to go for it. And that bold decision does not pay off.
And when you talk about bold, you're saying all caps?
All caps.
Yeah, without a doubt. Maybe they're telling their defense they have a lot of faith in them. I mean, that's how you have to spin it, is that you tell your defense, you know something? We were able to go for it there because you guys are so good. I'm not worried about things. That's the only explanation I can come up with in this situation.
He better get ready to spin it for that post-game pressure because you know he's going to be out.
He's going to have to spin it for his own locker room, frankly.
Quickly to Gronkowski. That's caught.
Gronk makes the catch.
At the 25 after a gain of 5. 5 yards. Now it's 3rd and 5.
Brings up 3rd.
They had great starting position to begin the drive, but now they look up at a 3rd and 5.
And Brady's gonna get sacked.
They push him back to the third.
Timeout, Carolina.
The Panthers gonna use the first of their timeouts.
This is gonna be a decently long field goal.
What to do next?
Daniel Carlson on for the field goal. A 51-yard
attempt. Kick is up.
That's running.
It's short.
He left it just short. No good. And this score will stay right where it is.
NFL kickers nowadays, they make things look so easy because normally from this range, about 2 out of 3. And this is not an easy kick.
Yeah, 20 years ago, you get where he was in that 50 range, maybe a little over. And it's a big kick, but now.
Caught by Jefferson!
You're like, whoa, what happened? And that's what we have here.
Yeah, you're right. 20 years ago, we were saying run some more plays and get close. closer. Now we think they're definitely within range, and you're exactly right. When it comes up short, there has to be
Vita Vea. And he got hit sticked.
Inside the 25. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And this is caught. And he will reach the 8-yard line before going
third reception.
15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
First and goal, Carolina.
They'll look to throw again. Flush to his right. This will be caught at about the 6.
But there is a flag.
He gets it forward for 4, maybe 5, but the flags fly. And this one could be coming back. We knew he was close to the line of scrimmage, and they say he stepped over.
Well, when you see him in that position, you think he's become a runner. As a DB, you start to react towards the line of scrimmage. They can often throw it over your head.
So the illegal forward pass also costs him a down, and now it's second and long. Flushed out right. That's complete. Right around the
he's in! Gerald Leverett finds the end zone. Hey, 2-2-2.
His first touchdown on the year. And the Panthers, they widen their lead. The Panther offense staying put. They'll go for 2. I'll let you do the analysis, partner, but with every touchdown pass, this young quarter. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by the free safety, Eric Berry.
And Eric Berry.
The 12, that's where it stops. The return is halted at the 12-yard line.
It's interesting that when it comes to two-point conversions, even heavy run teams tend to throw the ball in these situations. In this case, this one was intercepted.
Yeah, they weren't fooled. They were ready for the pass, picked it off. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half.
Three timeouts, 30 seconds left for the greatest quarterback of all time. Don't at me.
You're well on your own side of the field. What are we doing here, Coach Davis?
Well, I'm trying something on first down. And it's something that's safe. It's something that's been done many times before. A lot of people say it's not even worth trying, but I'm running a draw. I'm running a screen. I'm seeing if something pops. And if it does, that can alter my strategy and potentially get me some points. And if it doesn't work, well, then you just run the clock out and go to the locker room.
Mike Evans, the one he was looking for. And it's third and short.
Marcus Williams on the coverage.
Operating from the gun. Brady. And he's got a man. It's the tight end Howard complete.
That's going to be it.
The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. Brady now on first down.
And Brady's going to get sacked.
Too strong. They get there and take him down. Now a signal and a timeout call. As it comes with 9 seconds to go in this first half of play. They come up on second and long, and the pass protection just has not been there this afternoon.
Honestly, the edge rushers.
Looking for Godwin, and he's got him complete. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. The final shot before half for Brady. He hits Gronkowski on the
Gronk.
And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45.
And that'll do it for the first half.
The second half upon us sooner than we bargained for. Week 7, second half, let's do it.
J.K. Dobbins?
And they will get the football first. Second half action underway.
John Rouse.
And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
The Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire
and McCaffrey
time just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. He'll lose a yard on the play.
No way he got nothing.
3 yards on third down.
this defense needs here early in the second half to give it a little spark. I think their halftime adjustments, what they talked about, maybe it was just a little inspirational speech. Who knows? But looks like they're ready to go.
On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air.
Picked off!
Oh, incomplete. Nearly the pick they needed. They would have loved one there, but at least it does get them to fourth down.
Has been a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incomplete.
And look at this. It's a fake. And the gamble pays off. They get the first. So they get the first down. Maybe not a huge play in terms of yardage, but the fake punt does the job. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Now a draw play to McCaffrey.
When does that ever work?
Call it 8 yards, and it's second and 2.
3 yard line. 8 yards on the pickup. Brings up second and 2.
They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again.
McCaffrey goes nowhere.
And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 41. He'll lose a yard on the play, so now they need 3 yards on third down.
A loss of a yard on the play. And it's third down.
Out of the gun now on third down. And he finds a man. It's McCaffrey.
And he hits McCaffrey.
The first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive. First down. On first down, this is McCaffrey. And he's going to be stopped up at about the 47-yard line.
McCaffrey with the carry for Carroll.
A gain of 3, second down.
At the 47-yard line. It's a pickup of 3.
Here's a second and 7. That's complete to the tight end, Everett.
Boom.
And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs 22-yard line. A first down
boom.
There on a pickup of 25.
First down, Carolina.
They'll look to throw here on first down.
Who? What?
Jefferson, but this is intercepted. Carlton Davis picks it.
And that's going to be 6.
And there he goes. The 20.
Touchdown, Bucs.
He brings it back to the house for a Buccaneer TD. That's tough there. Starting to mount a good drive. Quarterback lets his guard down for just a moment, and it's going to bite him.
Yeah, I was just about to remark how in control of the game they were here in this third quarter, but that return for 6 points, we now have a game again.
Extra point by Carlson, up and good. And this is back to a 5-point game. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And this return will net positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line.
Around 27-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And last time, decent field position through the pick 6. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last, that didn't bother you too much last time.
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position, not try to take advantage of it.
Almost picked.
The defense makes a good play, too.
That he almost had it defensively. Could have been a game changer there in this second half. Instead, it's third down. Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
And the blitz does come. Oh, incomplete. Nearly the pick they needed. They would have loved one there, but at least it does get them to fourth down.
Yeah, we've been straight up pitiful on offense. Pitiful. Tie it up. I'm sorry, I'm
so football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw.
And that was a red zone pick, too.
Across the 45.
Complete.
23 yards on the play.
It's a gain of 20.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner.
Big time drive, guys. Big time drive.
Touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there. Not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed, too.
And he's got McCaffrey open, complete. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. It's another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards. 3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
That was exactly the look that we wanted.
That'll bring up second down. Ball on the 42 as they come up second and 10. They'll look to throw. Escaping the pressure right. He'll try and run.
And Lawrence is going to tuck it and run.
Here inside the 30. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs 14. A gain of 28 yards there and give him a first down.
All right, partner, I'm a defender, but I've got to express my admiration there. Moving around, making it happen, and instead of worrying about protecting himself, he goes and gets the first down. I've got to give it to him on that one.
Normally, you don't want your guy taking shots, your quarterback, but it's winning time here in the fourth quarter. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down.
Shaquille Barrett.
What a huge play at this point in the game. Shaquille Barrett in there to take him down, and the clock will roll.
Second down.
So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. They'll find Everett there, complete.
Timeout.
Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock stops with 23 seconds to go in the game.
And it's third down.
Back to throw. Eluding the pressure right.
No.
Incomplete.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage.
And they're going to call a timeout.
Now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them, and I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
Field goal, a 31-yard attempt.
No good.
He hooked it. No good, and this score will stay right where it is.
Buccaneers 22, Panthers 19.
So fire the cannons. It's a victory here for Tampa Bay. And it was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last points of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly
did. It was
very disappointing. You're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they planned to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever it was, it all came together in the second half. And
yeah. Anyway, yeah, that'll do it for this episode. Hope you all enjoyed. Have a good one, and I'm out.